Have you ever wondered how you can hold a glass without it just slipping through your fingers? The answer is a force called friction. Friction is a force that resists the motion of objects moving against each other. It is created when two surfaces rub together. If the surfaces are smooth and slippery, there will not be much friction between them. If the surfaces are rough, more friction will be produced. The more friction there is, the harder it is to move something. Even many surfaces that seem to be smooth are really quite lumpy at the microscopic level. When these surfaces rub together, their tiny bumps and valleys push against each other, which creates friction. The rougher the surface texture, the more friction there will be. Friction also increases with weight, so it's harder to move something heavy than something light. We rely on friction constantly in our everyday lives. For everything from holding on to something, to walking, to turning a doorknob, friction is necessary to perform ordinary tasks. It's what makes it possible for us to walk, run, and bike. When you drive a car, the brake pads create friction to help you stop. Friction is what lets us control how we move. There are also times when we want to reduce friction. For example, when we're going down a slide or sliding down a hill on our sled, we want to make sure there's as little friction as possible. This will help you go faster. Another time you would want less friction would be when ice skating. Smooth, flat ice reduces friction and allows skaters to glide quickly and smoothly across the surface. Friction can also cause problems, however. Too much friction where it is not wanted can make it difficult to move something across a surface. For example, using wheels to move something reduces the friction between an object and a surface and makes it easier to move. Another way to reduce friction is by using a lubricant. A lubricant is a substance that reduces friction between two objects, like oil, grease, or wax. A rusty bicycle chain might be difficult to move due to too much friction. Applying oil to the chain can make it move more easily again. Friction can be helpful or harmful, depending on the situation. When you're trying to move an object, friction creates resistance and makes it harder to move. But when you're braking in a car, friction creates resistance and slows the car down. Without friction, you would just keep going. Next time you're stuck trying to move a piece of furniture or walking on an icy sidewalk, remember that friction is working hard to help you out.